glad each of you are here for another special online version of Refuel. Together, we'll nourish and inspire our spiritual lives. This morning, we remember the importance of refueling our homes, connecting with God and each other as we go about our daily lives in the midst of these pandemic days. Let's sing as we lift our spirits together.
Welcome to Champlin United Methodist Church. We're very proud to say that we're a progressive and inclusive congregation here in the Northwest Metro. Whether you're here for the first time or more times than you can remember as you join us virtually, we're very glad that you're here, for all are welcome in this place. Now we want all the kids to gather around for some kids' time with Amy today. Come on down, Amy.
Now, I want you to think about this as a human heart. I know those look different, but let's just pretend for a little bit. I know we've been at home for a long time together, and sometimes it's hard to be nice and kind to one another. I want you to think about what your heart or someone else's heart might feel like when you say something mean or hurtful.
Right now. What that does to their heart.
help us to be kind to others. Amen.
Thanks, Amy. So this is the point in our refuel service where we stand and greet each other. So if you are watching the service with some other friends and family members today, go ahead and stand and greet them. For those of us that are here physically distant but sharing each other love, we're sending hugs this way and that way. Everybody, yeah, exactly. Big high five. We're sending our love across the miles. And as we call everybody back, we remember that our purpose as a congregation is to be an inclusive spiritual community serving others, and we're very glad you're here. As we continue in prayer this morning, I'm going to begin, and then we are going to hold portions of our world in our prayers. If you'd like to speak some prayers aloud at home, or write them down, if you've got a journal close by, you could sure do that. But we'll join in prayer for our world this day. And then we're going to end with the version of the Lord's Prayer that you find in the slides with you. We open up our hearts to God, who is always with us. Let us pray for our world, for people that are struggling for the next meal to eat, for those who are on the front lines caring for those who are most vulnerable. God, hear our prayer. For our community, for the teachers that have had to quickly adapt and the students to online learning, for those who are continuing to find their way in that process, God, hear our prayer. Together we lift all these people and situations before you. As our hearts are joined in prayer this morning, let's join together in this version of the Lord's Prayer from New Zealand. Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and that shall be, Father and Mother of us all, loving God in whom is heaven, the hallowing of your name echo through the universe. The way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. Your heavenly will be done by all created beings. Your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and come on earth. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. In times of temptation and test, strengthen us. From trial too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Amen. Amen. We are very glad that you've joined us here virtually today. And we are always holding you in our hearts. Our theme today, as the band has mentioned, is about refueling your home. And we're aware that as we gather together, that we're all missing being in this house of God, our church home, together. So we're going to take some time during the sermon time to take a little tour of the church and say some prayers, continue our prayers for the world as we remember our job is to pray at all times and in many, many ways. So we're working with our new mic here. Brian and I are traveling out of the sanctuary. So here we go. We're really glad you're with us. We're making our way into our beloved community room. Let me be careful with the spaghetti here. Okay, and here we're finding in the community room our sink that we notice on Sunday mornings. And here's a reminder that while we are living in quarantine, and Amy's gonna demonstrate for us, it's very important to what? Wash our hands. So, and how long do we do that for?
20 seconds.
Julia's here with us as well. And so let's remember how long this is supposed to go. Here, I'm gonna come around a bit.
You can sing the ABCs in your head.
Yep.
And that's approximately 20 seconds. Ready?
Yeah, ready, go, here we go. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, QRSTUV, WX, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? Keep washing your hands. All right, very good. Thanks, Amy and Julia. So hope you're enjoying your coffee as we're gathered for church here. Now we're making our way into the education wing, and we want to stop in the youth room while we're thinking about our kids. So here we are in the youth room. Here we go. Oh, Riley's jumping on the couch. We talked about this. Well,
but I'm the only one here.
But she's the only one here. And you know, sometimes it's fun to jump on the couch. Don't tell your parents. Okay. So here we're praying for our youth. We miss you as we gather every week. We're especially thinking of our seniors who are having their senior year end up very differently than they had hoped. Take a look at the dance video. I hope you get to see that came out this week, the virtual prom. I know you're celebrating in many ways, but let's pray for our kids. God, for all our youth who are learning new ways online to continue their schooling, and especially for our seniors who are having life turn out very differently than they've expected, and for their families, God, may they have a special awareness of your presence and feel your comfort and love, courage and inspiration around them. May you inspire them with what is to come and comfort them for what is now. Amen. Thanks, Riley.
I better erase the evidence.
She better erase the evidence. Okay, here we are, and as we continue in the education wing, we're heading toward the beautiful mural that was created not so very long ago. Karina's going to demonstrate the rainbow for us. Here's her rainbow moves. Can we see it? Here's Karina. Ta-da! Yes, thank you very much. So we're remembering the little kids in our congregation, and we are praying for you as you continue to learn from home, as you get outside to play. We hope you're enjoying God's beautiful creation, and we're gonna pray for our little kids too. Join me in a prayer. God, we pray for the little ones in our church, for these new ways that they are making their way in the world, for their families, that as Amy reminded us, we can continue to practice kindness, compassion, love, and peace in all things. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks, Karina. Yay. Now, it wouldn't be a trip back to the church if we didn't spend some time in the kitchen. So here we are. And have you ever wondered about these skylights in the kitchen? Like, are they on? Did we turn all the lights on? Oh, are they on? Are they off? Are they on? Are they off? Oh, wait, they're on. There they are. Okay, very good. Kathy's demonstrating from the side. I know, it's confusing, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, we almost got it. We got it. Okay. So once again, remember when you're in the kitchen, wash your hands. This is a wonderful time to be trying some new recipes with the extra time you might find that you have at home. I know Kathy's always doing that. I always try to do that too. And maybe it's something that you can make some extra to share with a neighbor or friend who you might know may be in need as well. So we remember that God is with us in the kitchen. Here we go. Now we're making our way to the community room. Everybody say hi, Kathy. Hi, Kathy. Okay, here we're making our way back into the community room where we again enjoy laughter. We shed tears with one another and comfort one another. This is a room that's held so many joyous occasions and will again. We are thinking of all of you as we remember what it means to live in community even across the miles. John's gospel reminds us that in God's house there are many dwelling places, and I'm going to share the scripture with us as we wrap up our sermon time today. This was Jesus' words to the disciples before he's getting ready to ascend to God after the resurrection. Jesus said, "Don't let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith in me as well. In God's house there are many dwelling places. Otherwise, how could I have told you that I was going to prepare a place for you? I am indeed going to prepare a place for you, and then I will come back to take you with me, that where I am, there you may be as well. You know the way that leads to where I am going." And Thomas replied, But we don't know where you're going, so how can we know the way? Jesus told him, I am myself the way. I am the truth and I am life. No one comes to Abba God but through me. If you really knew me, you would know Abba God also. From this point on, you know Abba God and you have seen God. Rabbi Philip said, show us Abba God and that will be enough for us. Jesus replied, have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still don't know me? Whoever has seen me has seen Abba God. So how can you say, show us your Abba? Don't you believe that I am in Abba God and God is in me? The words I speak are not spoken of myself. It is God living in me who is accomplishing the works of God. Believe me that I am in God and God is in me, or else believe because of the works that I do. The truth of the matter is, anyone who has faith in me will do the works that I do, and greater works besides. Why? Because I go to Abba God, and whatever you ask in my name, I will do, so that God may be glorified in me. Anything you ask in my name, I will do. So we remember that indeed in God's house, both indoors and out, there are many rooms. There's plenty of room for all of us, for we all belong to God. We all belong to each other. We all are going to continue our works of compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, and love as we move through these days together. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, we're going to make our way back to the... Oh! Wait a minute, there's something we forgot. One of the ways about being community is something we're still figuring out, and Scott's got the recycling bins. Oh my goodness. So we were like, is it trash? Is it organics? Is it recyclable? Which one would it be? What does it look like, Scott? Here, he's got it. He's totally on it. Organics. So here's a reminder from the trustees. We're gonna keep composting. Thank you, Scott. All right, here we go. So we're making our way back to the sanctuary. We're so glad you are with us, and we have a couple more songs to sing together as we remember what it means to refuel our homes. So we're gonna head back to the band.
Oh,
Thank you, band. A couple of quick announcements. So next week's theme will be about abiding in love. And please tune in for a special Lord's Prayer compilation that we're going to have that's featuring several members of the congregation that we're really looking forward to. And we're holding you in our prayers and love as we continue through another week together. So now our band's got our closing song, Walking on Sunshine. So get ready to sing. Thanks again for joining us today. May God bless you and keep you and hold you in the palm of God's hand this week and always. See you soon. Virtual hugs. Amen. Okay. Awesome.